Look at this map that shows the countries with the most people with blue eyes in the world. Now look at this map that shows the countries with the most people with naturally blonde hair in the world. As you can see, there is a strong overlap in Scandinavia and the northeast of Europe. Countries like Finland, Sweden, Norway, Estonia, as well as Iceland, which was settled by the Norse, have the highest levels of people with blonde hair and blue eyes in the world. Why is this though? And when did this phenomenon of blonde hair and blue eyes first develop? And how did it spread to Europe? Now let's start by looking at the origins of blonde hair and blue eyes in general. First up is blue eyes, and I often see people on the internet today still quote outdated information on the origins of blue eyes in general. This is because the initial research came from a team from the University of Copenhagen in 2008 who identified the genes involved in blue eye colour developing in humans. To be more specific, they identified a mutation in the HER2 gene which influences the expression of the adjacent OCA2 gene, a gene that is involved in melanin production. Now we know that people with blue eyes have less melanin in the layers of the iris than people with brown eyes. This is basically a result of this mutation on the HER2 gene, which acts as a switch on the OCA2 gene, basically downregulating the activity of this OCA2 gene, which is involved in melanin production, thus reducing melanin output, leading to blue eyes. The authors hypothesised that this mutation arose in an individual who lived in the Black Sea region sometime between 6,000 and 10,000 years ago. Although the mechanism of HER2 OCA2 is broadly correct, this origin story is outdated, as we know that blue eyes are older than 6,000 to 10,000 years ago, even though some people still recite this today. A 2016 study, for instance, that looked at the genetic history of Ice Age Europe found this mutation in the HER2 area in individuals who lived between 13,000 and 14,000 years ago in the Caucasus in Italy. And a 2020 study that looked at skin colour and vitamin D suggested that blue eyes could have first developed around 42,000 years ago, arguably around the time that modern humans entered Europe. So we know that blue eyes have a long history in Europe in general, potentially evolving very soon after modern humans arrived in Europe, according to some theories at least. We also know that Western hunter-gatherers had blue eyes to a large degree, the ancient hunter-gatherers who lived in parts of Western and Central Europe. Yet we know that the majority of these Western hunter-gatherers had dark hair, not blonde hair. Perhaps a very small amount of Western hunter-gatherers had blonde hair, but this combination of blue eyes and blonde hair was exceedingly rare in early Western hunter-gatherers, if present at all. So when did blonde hair enter the picture, and how did this trait arrive in Europe in any meaningful way? Well, ancient DNA analysis has revealed that the oldest fossil known to carry the mutated allele RS128-21256 of the KITLG gene, which is responsible for blonde hair in modern Europeans, is a 17,000-year-old ancient North Eurasian specimen from southern Siberia. More specifically, the remains were from a complex of archaeological sites known as Avantova Gora. The blonde allele was found in a site known as Avantova Gora 3, where archaeologists found the remains of two different females, the atlas of an adult female and the mandible and five lower teeth of a teenage girl estimated to be around 14 to 15 years old. But how did this blonde hair allele arrive in Europe? Well, it seems that the hundreds of millions of copies of this blonde allele entered continental Europe by way of a massive population migration from the Eurasian steppe, by a people who had substantial ancient North Eurasian ancestry. It appears that this blonde allele first entered Europe through migrations of Eastern hunter-gatherers. Three Eastern hunter-gatherers from Sweden, Russia and Ukraine all had this allele associated with blonde hair, for example, as detailed in the supplementary information of a study on the genomic history of Southeastern Europe, which analysed 225 individuals from Southeastern Europe who lived between 12,000 and 500 BC. Yet Eastern hunter-gatherers largely had brown eyes, not blue eyes. So when did we see this combination of blue eyes and blonde hair in Europe for the first time in any meaningful way? Well, it was this mixing of Western hunter-gatherers and Eastern hunter-gatherers that created this appearance of blonde hair and blue eyes in Europe in a significant way for the first time. What is even more interesting is that if we look at the map today of the countries with the highest number of people with blue eyes and blonde hair, namely in Scandinavia, Finland and around the Baltic area, these regions would have been the exact locations where there would have been lots of mixing between these Eastern and Western hunter-gatherer groups thousands of years ago. We know, for instance, that Scandinavian hunter-gatherers are a group that was formed due to the initial migration of Western hunter-gatherers that moved into Scandinavia after the last ice age from the south, and then a later migration from the north of Eastern hunter-gatherers. Thus, this combination of blue eyes and blonde hair has deep historical roots in places like Scandinavia due to the mixing of groups from the east and the west, where the genetics for blue eyes and blonde hair first met in a significant way. Now, if you're enjoying this video, please consider subscribing. But the story doesn't end here though. What impact did the Indo-Europeans have on the spread of blonde hair and blue eyes into Europe? Anyone that's seen any previous videos of mine will know that there was a major migration from the Pontic-Caspian steppe beginning around 3000 BC associated with the Yamnaya culture. This episode had a major impact on the genetics of various parts of Europe as I go through in my genetic history series on various different countries. And the migrations from the Pontic-Caspian steppe were the third major episode in the genetic history of Europe and followed the early European farmers that brought kind of Anatolian ancestry into various parts of Europe, and these people largely had dark hair and brown eyes. What did the Yamnaya look like though? And were they involved in the spread of blonde hair and blue eyes into Europe? Well, initially there was an argument that these migrations during the Bronze Age from the steppe helped to spread blonde hair into Europe, yet more recent research has suggested this wasn't quite the case. A 2022 study, for instance, found that the Yamnaya largely had brown eyes and brown hair, with the Yamnaya potentially looking more like this reconstruction. This is not to say that some Yamnaya didn't have blonde hair, or at least didn't carry the genetic mutation for blonde hair, but the Yamnaya mostly had brown hair, and probably had less of an impact in the spread of blonde hair into Europe than initially thought, although they potentially brought a little more of these genes in, as part of their ancestry was ancient North Eurasian. What is interesting though is that cultures that were connected to the Yamnaya seem to have higher levels of both blue eyes and blonde hair than the Yamnaya. It seems that the Beakers had blue eyes and blonde hair at higher levels than the Yamnaya, for example, and helped bring these traits into Britain after the previous major migration into Britain was with the early European farmers. The corded bear culture and the battle axe people also seem to have higher levels of blonde hair and blue eyes compared to the Yamnaya. A 2019 study, for example, that looked at the genomic ancestry of the Scandinavian battle axe culture and their relation to the broader corded bear horizon, analysed 11 individuals from modern-day Sweden, Estonia and Poland, who lived between 3000 and 1600 BC. They found that these people displayed a mixed appearance, with both light and dark hair and brown and blue eyes, with some people within these cultures having this combination of blue eyes and blonde hair. Perhaps the reason that the Beakers and the corded bear people had higher levels of blue eyes and blonde hair compared to the Yamnaya was because that even though these people had some steppe ancestry in them, they had also mixed with the local populations of Europe and they potentially picked up these traits from them. There were probably other selective pressures as well that helped these traits of blonde hair and blue eyes be selected for over time. But before we look at these selective pressures, I would like to quickly thank my Patreon members for voting an exclusive poll on what video topics you want to see and voting for this video topic. If you would like to vote for what video topics I make videos on, I will put a link in the description below to my Patreon page. Thanks for your support. Now, sexual attractiveness could have helped blonde hair and blue eyes become more common after the initial mixing of Western and Eastern hunter-gatherers, with people with these traits perhaps more likely to reproduce and in greater numbers. We know today, for instance, that blonde is generally the most popular hair colour for women to dye their hair, and this fondness of blonde hair seems to go back thousands of years down through history, as I detail in my video on the origins of blonde hair. Blue eyes are also considered attractive by many, with this combination of blonde hair and blue eyes still striking today. Blue eyes also would have probably had an adaptive advantage as well in Northern Europe, given how dark the winter months are in parts of Sweden and Finland, say. So overall, this combination of blonde hair and blue eyes has a long history and involves various factors, from genetic mutations to the mixing of ancient populations, to selective pressures perhaps helping to select this combination over time, increasing its frequency. Other factors such as the Vikings having a genetic impact on so many parts of Europe could also have compounded all this, spreading this Scandinavian ancestry into places such as Iceland and Britain and Ireland, for example. But speaking of blue eyes, what is the reason for blue eyes? To find out, please click here. Thanks for watching, please subscribe and hit the bell, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you would like to vote for video topics, the topics I make videos on, please check out my Patreon page, I'll put a link in the description below. But yeah, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.